name is Rod Olson, and I'm from Calgary, Alberta, and I am a spin farmer. My brother-in-law and I started Leaf and Lyre in 2010, so this is our fourth season as Leaf and Lyre Urban Farms. He was here from University of Toronto taking a break from his PhD, and had always wanted to learn a little bit more about farming. I grew up on a farm in central Alberta, and so, you know, was gardening since the time I was four, and have moved to different cities across Canada, Vancouver, central Alberta, Lacombe area. And each time I found myself growing my own food, which is something that is part of my story, part of something that I love to do. And so when Chad moved here, he wanted to learn, eventually wanting to kind of live on the fringes of a city and live sustainably. And so the two of us thought, well, why not give it a shot now? We can learn everything that we need to know about the plants by starting this spin farming adventure, is what we'll call it. So we downloaded the business plan from spinfarming.ca, which is Wally Saswich, who's a market gardener in Saskatoon. And so he, along with a research in the States, put together the business plan, basically, and it's a very detailed. You can know nothing and download this $80 business plan and begin growing and selling produce in your first season. So it was a very user-friendly, very user-friendly plan. So when we started out, we weren't really sure how Calgary would respond, and we were fortunate enough to get a spot on CBC radio interview, and they decided to kind of track us through the first summer. And every time we were on the radio or in the media, we would get reams of people saying, "Oh, you can use my yard." And so how we do it is we look for free land, and so homeowners have access to their backyards, front yards. And they give us access to the land. They also provide a bit of watering, irrigation. And then in exchange, we give the homeowner some of the organic produce. And then the rest we sell at farmers markets. We have a CSA, and we sell to local restaurants as well. CSA is a community shared agriculture. And so that's where the consumer will pay the farmer up front at the first of the season. And so we as farmers are paid. All we need to do now is deliver the fresh organic produce throughout the summer. And that what it really allows us to do is purchase seed, purchase soil amendments. And so all of our costs come at the beginning of the season. And so it's a great relationship for us as the farmer. And then on the flip side, the CSA shareholders receive this beautiful locally grown produce that. And they get to find out, they get to know who their farmer is. And in fact, I think we are adorning the fridges of some of our CSA shareholders so that they can point to, that's my farmer right there. And we also wanted to see if it was a viable business opportunity for people in an urban setting. And so you start pretty small, but each year that we've been in operation, we've seen dramatic increases in our productivity, and then therefore the financial kickback as well. The website, the spin farming website, tells you that on a half acre of land you can generate about a $50,000 income, which we haven't seen yet in Calgary. We've got some growing challenges here with low overnight temperatures and a very heavy clay-based soil. So we find that we spend a lot of time building our soil, you know, probably as much as that as we are growing food. And so I think it's just going to be it's going to take us a little longer here in the Calgary climate to get to that 50,000 benchmark. So we've been around for 4 years, but there's three new companies that started up this year, and so they just start small. They've got other part-time jobs. But they're wanting to participate in this local food movement, and so us and a few of the the longer standing farmers. We've come around all of these new ones, and we've created an organization called the YYC Metro Growers. We're trying to kind of working together. We're trying to reduce some of the costs. So every market that we go to, we have to pay a fee. And so if we come together under one banner, because we're all pretty, we're on the smaller scale, we can all fit under one tent. Well, our produce can, maybe we as people can't. But then we could rotate the markets as well, so that we're marketing our product every day of the week, whereas now most of us have one market a week, and that's pretty much what we can manage based on our time involvement and that. So working together, we're hoping to kind of increase the economic viability of it. And then just as a not-for-profit, we're hoping to increase the interest in our product as well. We'd love to have a kind of a food hub type situation where we have a commercial cooling, commercial kitchen, so that we can have our product cooled. It could be a pickup spot for CSAs for the restaurants. The kitchen could be a teaching kitchen, and so we're starting to work towards that. And so it's we want it to be a not-for-profit entity as well, because we're finding that a lot of people want to know about farming, but a lot of people aren't ready to take the jump. And so I think education is a huge piece that we want to tap into. And so currently, schools are nervous of having for-profit businesses, even though it's what we call social entrepreneurship. It's not your typical business structure, because we're seeking to create a better society with what we're doing, with how we grow food. And so that will give us access to schools. Eventually, we'd love to have access to hospitals and then to senior centers. And so it's all of these kind of fringe populations. There are some food deserts here, even here in Canada, in Calgary, where a senior will have only access to their 7-Eleven. And so we'd love to be able to start addressing some of those issues, kind of around food philanthropy. So there's a lot happening at the same time, where we're trying to create our businesses, but also recognizing that there's this huge education piece and this huge need for locally produced clean, good, fair food, that is going to kind of keep our aging populations healthy as well. Yeah, with the not-for-profit, I think ideally we'd love to have an online feature so that orders can be done that way, and then. Because with Twitter and Facebook and like all of the social media, there's a lot of people that are passionate about this, but when they leave their office, they do what they always do and stop at the grocery store and then head home. And so if there's ways for us to kind of be in their face in the social media world, then maybe we can start to change some of that behavior so that some of our beautiful produce gets into their hands.